Greetings and welcome once again to another episode of Sonic Odyssey, the music video channel dedicated to bringing you the last 5 decades or so of music in review and discussion format. Before we dive into today's topic, let's get the housekeeping out of the way. Please be sure to like the video by clicking the thumbs up button. That helps YouTube get the video out to more people, which is always better. And also you can subscribe to the channel by clicking the subscribe button, and if you like, you can click the little bell icon that appears next to it, and that way you'll be alerted each time I post a new video. And you can also share the video by hitting the share button, and there you'll see there are different social media networks available, such as Facebook and Twitter, and you can share the video with your friends and let them know that you have enjoyed it. Lastly, I would humbly ask you to consider visiting my Patreon page. There's a link in the show description right below, and there you'll see the different tiers that are available if you enjoy what you see and would like to help support the channel. That would be greatly appreciated. Thank you very much in advance for doing so. That's the housekeeping out of the way. Now on to today's topic. Today we're going to be discussing the band from California, which goes by the name of Primus, and in specific we'll be looking at their sophomore release, their first major label release, which was in 1991 and is entitled Sailing the Seas of Cheese.
Throw it over four, madam, made this little sway into his mighty throat. Many a fat alley rat met his demise while starting point blank down the cavernous barrel. This saw some prowling machine. Truly a wonder of nature, this urban predator. Tommy the cat and many a story to tell. But it was a rare occasion, such as this, that he did.
The snippet that I just played is from the 9th track of the album entitled Tommy the Cat. I felt it was probably the best choice as an opening sound clip to give you an idea of what Primus is all about sonically, because it does feature all three members of the band playing together. In addition, on display is the sound that typifies the Primus sound through most of their discography, and that is a bass-first approach to playing. So, who are Primus? Well, they were formed in 1984 by bassist, vocalist, and lyricist Les Claypool alongside Todd Huth on guitars. Over the ensuing 5 years, they would go through a number of drummers before settling on Tim Alexander in 1989. It was, however, in 1989 that Todd Huth left the band and was replaced on guitars by Larry Lalonde. The current lineup of the band is still Les, Larry, and Tim, but they did go through a few changes, just a little bit on a couple of albums over the course of their recording career, but this is the classic lineup, and the lineup that recorded on the album we're looking at today, Sailing the Seas of Cheese. They went about breaking their recording career in a slightly different manner than a lot of other bands would. In 1989, with Les's father providing capital on loan, Primus recorded a few concerts at Berkeley, and from those recordings made an assemblage of songs released as an album entitled Suck on This. That was their first album release, but it wasn't their first studio release. That would come in 1990 and was entitled Frizzle Fry. This album received a fair deal of local popularity and helped to get the band recognized by a major label, Interscope, and they were picked up by Interscope for their first major label release and their sophomore album, the album we're looking at today, Sailing the Seas of Cheese, in 1991. There are 13 tracks on the album, but two of these tracks clock in at under a minute and serve as intro tracks to the A side and B side of the LP or cassette release. And so the majority of the music is in the 11 other songs, which comprise the roughly 46 minutes of music on the album. And they had a number of successes from this album. They had three singles released for the songs Jerry Was a Race Car Driver, the played before Tommy the Cat, and the song Those Damn Blue Collar Tweakers. The first two of those songs were turned into videos and got a great deal of TV playtime on the music video channel MTV. And their popularity was so great, in fact, that especially for the song Tommy the Cat, when they would perform in concert, Les Claypool would have to, introduce each song by saying, "The next song is not Tommy the Cat," before playing the other songs in the show. Sailing the Seas of Cheese served as a great vehicle for getting the band over. It may not have had the chart success of its contemporaries, but it did sell enough copies to reach gold status in 1991, and ultimately received platinum status as of, I think, 2001, and in 2013 they released a deluxe version of the album, which included a DVD or Blu-ray, depending on the package you purchased, which had the album in a 5.1 surround sound mix, so quite the treat if you get that physical copy. Among the other treats of the album are the songs such as American Life, Is It Luck, Fish On, 11, which is a song in the oddly used or rarely used time signature of 11-8, and the song which we're going to hear a little bit from now, entitled Sergeant Baker.
One, two!
This portion of the song, Sergeant Baker, is the breakdown, and it's introduced by Les barking out 1-2 as a marching tempo, as the song does deal with kind of a abusive drill sergeant character, and then goes into these crushing and pummeling chords on both the bass and the guitar, as well as having the pounding drums of Mr. Alexander coming in. So it really has a very aggressive and forward approach in the presentation. And also you get a really nice little bit of guitar work that you can hear. It's not so forward in the mix, but it's present there. And so I want to make clear that it is the style of Primus to have this bass heavy sound, but the guitar work, while it is a little bit pushed in the back into the side, it does still have a strong effect and influence on the album, and it does get prominence enough of place within the mix. Larry Lalonde's solo in this breakdown is a good window in, an oral window, if you would, into the style of performance that really typifies what Primus does, and that is their live performances, more so than their studio recordings. This is a band that truly shines most brightly when they're performing live. And they do have a style that is somewhat akin to a jam band to a certain degree. They are very much likely to, in the confines of a track that they're performing, just improvise and have solos and allow the song to just play out and drag on, and they don't feel a great necessity to mirror precisely their recorded studio output, but rather create the artistic sensation and expression while they're performing their songs for the audience in the performances. It really is a brilliant style of playing that they have. And so the studio albums do a good job of capturing their style and their ideas, but their expression is probably best experienced live. Critics have said of this album that it is perhaps their strongest and tightest example of the riff-oriented and groove-oriented style of music that they play, but it is difficult to kind of say what genre they precisely fall into. Primus does make a great deal of use of elements of metal and thrash, but they also use those elements and comfortably rest them within the realm of funk. So there is this tendency by a lot of critics to classify them in the genre of funk metal, but they don't really classify themselves in such a manner, and in fact I've had experience of other people referring to them as avant-garde music. I give Sailing the Seas of Cheese 4 stars out of 5. I like the album very much. I bought it when it came out. I've been a fan of them since I was introduced to their first studio album, Frizzle Fry, and I highly recommend that you check them out and listen to it. It is really a great album, and it does have probably their most radio-friendly songs that they've ever performed. They did have in their later career, such as the Brown Album and the Tales from the Punch Bowl and Pork Soda, they did have chart success, but Sailing the Seas of Cheese is probably the best representation of them in the studio for what they give on the stage. And that really is, as I stated earlier, the best way to experience this band. And so if you can get your hands on a copy of their 2004 released DVD, Hallucinogenetics, I highly recommend it. It is a brilliant concert performance, and if you also have the chance to see them, I know that they play a lot of smaller venues around the United States especially, you can take in this extraordinary phenomena that is Primus and their marvelous musicianship. Les Claypool is a virtuoso. He is maybe not in the same class as Stanley Clark from last week's video on Rite of Strings, but he is undeniably one of the geniuses of the performance of bass guitar in the last few decades. So I strongly recommend that you check them out. I don't give the album a higher overall star rating because I do feel that the production, you know, putting the guitar a little bit in the back and to the left of the sound does take it a little bit down. It would be perhaps a slightly higher rating if it were a little bit more even-handed, but it is the style they present. However, again, when they play live, there's much more equanimity for them. There is more fairness in the levels of sound, and you still have the very forward bass performance. But Larry Lalonde's guitar does get a real freedom that is not afforded him in the studio, or at least on this album. So be sure to check it out. It's a great album, Sailing the Seas of Cheese by Primus from 1991, and I'm sure you'll be delighted and glad that you did. I know it's available on every digital distribution network that's available, but you can also get physical copies. As I said before, the deluxe version that was released in 2013 does come with a DVD or Blu-ray on your choice as you select it, and you'll be able to enjoy the album in a 5:1 surround sound mix, which is, from my perspective, a wonderful way to enjoy music. I have at least a dozen different albums that have been released on surround sound, and they are just breathtaking to listen to hear the mix, you know, such as Opeth and Rush and a few other bands that I have. They're so beautiful in the sound staging for a surround sound mix. So I highly recommend you check it out. And thank you very much for your time and attention. Until next time, peace, stay well, bye-bye.